Hello students, today we are going to find out derivative of inverse trigonometric functions. So we are going to take first sine inverse x. So let y equals to sine inverse x. Okay students, so therefore x equal to sin y. Students, we know that domain of sin inverse function is minus 1 to 1, means x must belongs to minus 1 to 1 and y must belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Correct. So now x equals to sin y. Now students, let's differentiate both sides with respect to x. So differentiating, both sides with respect to x. So when we differentiate it both sides with respect to x, then x derivative 1, sine derivative cos, sine y cos y, y derivative dy by dx, because we cannot get the derivative of y with respect to x. That's why we are writing here dy by dx. Now students, we have to find out dy by dx. So dy by dx equals to 1 upon cos y. Okay. So dy by dx equals to 1 upon root 1 minus sine square y. Okay student, because we know that sine square y plus cos square y equals to 1. Sine square y plus cos square y equals to 1. Correct student. Cos square y equals to 1 minus sin square y. Cos y equals to root 1 minus sin square y. Okay, that's why I have written at the place of cos y root 1 minus sin square y. Now students, dy by dx equals to 1 upon root 1 minus x square, because sin y equals to x. So that's why we can write at the place of sin y x. So it will become 1 upon root 1 minus x square. So this is the derivative of sin inverse x. So sin inverse x derivative 1 upon root 1 minus x square. One thing here we have to remember, x belongs to minus 1 to 1, but if x equals to 1, then it will be 0. That's why here in this case we have to mention x belongs to minus 1 to 1. 1 is not included, So y belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. And pi by 2 not included, student. Okay? So you remember, in inverse trigonometric function, in the derivative of sine inverse x is 1 upon root 1 minus x square, and x must belongs to minus 1 to 1, where minus 1 and 1 not included. Okay, students? Okay then. Now, so similarly, you can find out derivative of cos inverse x. Now, students, we are going to find out derivative of tan inverse x. So let y equals to tan inverse x. Therefore, x equal to tan y. Correct. Now, students, differentiating both sides, with respect to x. So when we differentiate it both sides with respect to x, then x derivative is 1. Tan derivative, we know that sec square y. Tan derivative is sec square. Tan y derivative, sec square y. And y derivative we cannot obtain, so we can write dy by dx. So dy by dx equals to student 1 upon sec square y. Okay. So dy by dx equals to 1 upon sec square y, can be written as 1 plus tan square y, because we know that sec square y minus tan square y equals to 1. Therefore, sec square y equals to 1 plus tan square y. Now, students, dy by dx equals to 1 upon, at the place of tan y, we can write x. Okay, so it will become 1 plus x square, because tan y equals to x. That's why we can write at the place of tan y, x, students. So dy by dx equals to 1 upon 1 plus x square. So this is the derivative of tan inverse x. Okay, students. So we can say derivative of tan inverse x equals to 1 upon 1 plus x square. Similarly, student, we can find out derivative of cot inverse x. We are going to find out derivative of sec inverse x. Let y equals to sec inverse x. So for sec inverse x, x must belongs to r minus minus 1 to 1. So x equals to sec y. Now, students, differentiating both sides with respect to x. So x derivative 1, sec y derivative sec y tan y. Now y derivative, you know, we cannot be obtained. So that's why we can write here dy by dx. So dy by dx equals to 1 upon sec y tan y. Now student, tan y should not be equal to 0. It means y should not be equal to 0 because we know that tan 0 equals to 0. And we also know that tan pi equals to 0. That's why y should not be equal to pi. And you know x is not equal to minus 1 to 1. Now students, we know that sec square y minus tan square y equals to 1. Sec square y minus 1 equals to tan square y. So tan y equals to root sec square y minus 1. So at the place of tan y, we can write sec square y minus 1. So at the place of sec y, we can write x. And at the place of sec y, here also we can write x. So dy by dx equals to 1 upon x root s square minus 1. But before writing this, we will take the value of x. X value may be greater than 1. Okay, according to the domain of sec inverse x. So if x is greater than 1, okay students, then y must belong to 0 to pi by 2. Because y value, sec inverse value will be positive then if x is greater than 1. And tan y is also greater than 0. So dy by dx equals to 1 upon x root s square minus 1. Because x value is greater than 1, so it will not be equals to 0. Now should case second, if x less than minus 1, then if x less than minus 1, so y must belong to pi by 2 to pi, because value of sec will be negative. Okay, and we know that in second quadrant sec is negative. That's why if x less than minus 1, then y must belong to pi by 2 to pi. And tan y value also in second quadrant is 0, less than 0, negative. So tan y is also less than 0. So tan y equals to minus sec square y minus 1. Okay. So tan y equals to minus root x square minus 1. So dy by dx equals to, it will be negative. At the place of sec y, we can write x. And at the place of root sec square y minus 1, we will write minus x square minus 1. Minus root x square minus 1. So there are two cases. That's why we can write directly derivative of sec inverse x equals to 1 upon mod of x. Okay. Root x square minus 1. Okay students. So derivative of sec inverse x equals to 1 upon mod of x root x square minus 1. Okay, it depends on the value of x. If x value greater than 1, then we will write 1 upon x root s square minus 1. If value of x less than 1, minus 1, then we can write 1 upon minus x root s square minus 1. By the same way, we can find out derivative of cos inverse x. Okay, students.